Welcome to the spoken tutorial on engineering drawing with GeoGebra. Orthographic projection of a regular hexagon. Objectives: in this tutorial we will learn how to draw the orthographic projection of a regular hexagon to demonstrate the effect of changes in dimensions on the projections of a plane using GeoGebra. We will do this through animation. Prerequisites: you will need to have a working knowledge of GeoGebra. Please go through the tutorials on the Spoken Tutorial website on GeoGebra if required. You also need to have a good knowledge of engineering drawing. Here we are using GeoGebra 3.2.40.0 on Ubuntu 10.10. Now let us first open GeoGebra. Click on the Applications menu, select Science and then click on GeoGebra. You will be mostly working on the graphics window. You can use the icons in the toolbar to draw the constructions. You can also do this by writing the commands in the input box. I have opened a GeoGebra file that shows the basic principles of orthographic projection. In engineering drawing, we draw an object in 3D space using views that appear on the planes of projection. The front view, top view and the profile view are used to visualize the geometrical object. The horizontal plane HP, the vertical plane VP and the profile plane PP are the principal planes of projection. In an orthographic projection, an object is viewed along parallel lines. The lines are perpendicular to the plane of the drawing. The lines drawn from a given view to obtain the other views are called generators. Let us now draw the orthographic projection of a regular hexagon. Click on File New to open a new GeoGebra window. Select the Segment Between Two Points icon. Click twice on the graphics window to get a line segment. Right click on one point and select Rename and enter X in the window that opens. Similarly, label the other point Y. We have drawn the XY line. You will notice that when we create the line segment, the points, lines, etc. of this construction appear on the algebraic window. Point coordinates, distances, areas, equations, etc. are also shown here. You can use the algebraic window to select a particular object and make necessary changes and preview the same in the graphics window. You will learn more about this later in the tutorial. Select the Insert Text icon. Enter VP in the window that opens. Similarly, write HP below the XY line. The plane above the XY line is the VP and the plane below the XY line is the HP. The intersection of the HP and the VP is the XY line. Here we will draw the top view and front view of a plane surface, a regular hexagon. Let us construct the hexagon now. Click the arrow in the polygon icon. Select the regular polygon icon. You will have to specify two points and enter the number of vertices. Click twice on the graphics window and enter the number of vertices in the window that opens. Since we are drawing a regular hexagon, I will enter 6. A regular hexagon appears on the drawing pad. To draw the top view, we have to draw the generators of the hexagon. To do this, we will select the perpendicular line icon. Now let us draw the perpendicular lines through the vertices of the hexagon. Select a point, then select the XY line. You will get the perpendicular through the point. Draw the other generator similarly. Next, we have to mark the required points on the generator to get the top view. The top view of the hexagon is a line. Here we view the hexagonal plane on the HP. Use the New Point tool and the Line Segment tool to draw the top view. Select the New Point icon. Use the grid to mark a point 2 units away from the XY line. Click on the generator to create a point. Similarly, create a point on the other generator. Now select the segment between two points icon. Select the two points. A line segment appears on the screen. This is the top view. This is the front view we have drawn earlier. As you can see, some of the vertices are coincident. When we show the generators, the construction lines should not be visible. What we see in the final drawing are the lines from the vertices of the hexagon on the front view to the points on the line which is the top view. To To draw this, use the segment between two points tool. Select the topmost vertex of the hexagon, then select the point on the top view. Similarly, draw the other generators. Now hide the construction lines. To do this, right-click on the object and deselect the Show Object option. We have drawn the generators. We will now look at the formatting so that we can arrive at the final drawing. Here we have hidden the grid and the axis as this is required only for purpose of construction. Here we have shown the projection lines. This is required to arrive at the final drawing. You can view the object properties of the geometrical object you create. Select the object and right click to get the object menu. Select object properties. A new window opens. You can choose any color on the color menu of the object properties. Use this to show the top view and the front view. Preview the object in the graphics window. Here we have selected black and gray. As you can see, the sides of the hexagon are black and the inside of the hexagon is gray. The lines that are not visible in the given view and actual lines are drawn as dotted lines. Select the line H under Objects Line and preview the selection in the graphics window. You can select a dotted line on the Style menu here. You can choose to hide the object by unchecking the Show Object option. Go to Basic, select the line under Objects Line, uncheck the Show Object option. Use this to hide lines and points used in the construction. Now let us view the generators. To do this, click the line segment, say K under Object Segment. You can change the line thickness using the slider. Generators are thin lines. Use this option to make thin lines when you draw generators. You can use the Object Properties menu to hide points used in the construction. Click the circular icon beside the name of the point under Objects Point. Similarly, hide the other points in the drawing. As you can see, when we click the icon, the point disappears on the graphics window. Now let us label the drawing. Use the Insert Text tool to do this. We will first label the vertices of the hexagon in the front view. Select the Insert Text icon. Click in the graphics window to place the cursor where you want the text to appear. Enter the name of the point in the window that opens. Label all the points similarly. Now let us label the points projected in the top view. Now we will add a text annotation to show the top view and the front view. We will use the Insert Text tool to do this. Select the Insert Text icon. Let us put the text top view here. Click inside the graphics window. A new window opens. Enter the text in the edit box and click on OK. Now let us add the dimensioning. Use the segment between two points tool to do this. Click twice on the graphics window to get the line segment. Hide the points created in the construction. Similarly, draw the other dimension lines. Change the point style on the object properties menu to show the arrowheads. Now use the Insert Text tool to show the length of the side of the hexagon. We have drawn the dimension lines. You can view the commands on the command list here. You can draw a polygon or a perpendicular using commands too. Now let us add an annotation to our drawing. For this we will use the text command. Orthographic projection of a regular hexagon. Select the move icon. Now select the title text and drag it to the required position. In any engineering drawing problem, you will have to visualize a geometrical object and its transformations. Here we are showing the grid on the axis, which will be useful in viewing the transformation. You can use the move icon or sliders to change the dimensions of the geometrical figure. You might also want to look at applets. You can create a dynamic web page with input parameters and view the GeoGebra animation in the form of an applet. You can read more about this on the Spoken Tutorial website. In engineering drawing, we view a geometrical object in 3D space with views in 2D space. Generally, the top view and the front view of the geometrical object is used, but the right side view, left side view, bottom view and rear view can also be used in this regard. In an orthographic projection, a geometrical object is viewed perpendicularly. Hence, the object is in true shape in the top view or the front view. The front view is in true shape here. Let us see how to use the transformations using GeoGebra. You can view the variation in the length of sides and in the number of vertices. Here we are showing the vertices of the hexagon as we will use the points to increase the side length using the Move tool. Select the Move icon. Now select one of the three points and drag the mouse to increase the side length. We see the variation in the size of the polygon. We will now demonstrate the change in the number of sides using animation. I have opened a GGB file, which is the GeoGebra file format that shows an animation created with GeoGebra. You can learn more about making animations with sliders on the Spoken Tutorial website. We will use a slider to vary the number of sides. Right click on the slider and click on Animation On. You will observe the change in the shape of the polygon. The number of vertices changes from 3 to 10, which is set on the slider. You can view the change in the top view and the front view with a change in the number of sides. Right click on the slider and click on Animation On to stop the animation. This is how the geometrical object is visualized with CAD using GeoGebra. This brings us to the end of this spoken tutorial. To summarize, we have seen how GeoGebra can be used to draw the orthographic projection of a regular hexagon to demonstrate by animation the effect of changes in dimensions and the projections of a plane using GeoGebra. We have learned how to make geometrical constructions using GeoGebra, how to change the parameters to view the corresponding changes in the geometrical figures, how to draw the different views using GeoGebra. Assignment: draw the orthographic projection of a regular pentagon, show the transformation with variation in position with respect to HP and VP, with movement of vertices, when base is on HP, when one of the corners is on HP, at a given distance in front of VP. Watch the video titled "What is a Spoken Tutorial" on the Spoken Tutorial website. You can download the tutorial if required. The Spoken Tutorial project team conducts workshops using Spoken Tutorials, gives certificates to those who pass an online test. Acknowledgements. The Spoken Tutorial project is a part of the Talk to a Teacher project. It is supported by the National Mission on Education through ICT, MHRD, Government of India. More information on this mission is available on the Spoken Tutorial website. This is Komal from SJCE Mysore. Hope you enjoyed this Spoken Tutorial. Thank you. Have a good day.